Hey guys, I'm Venkat, and in this video, we'll discuss two common tasks that are usually asked in a SQL interview. Write a SQL query to extract only alphabets from a given alphanumeric string. Similarly, write a SQL query to extract only numbers from a given alphanumeric string. This database table has only one column, and it contains both numbers and alphabets. Now, the task at hand is to write a query that extracts numbers and letters into separate columns, as you can see here. If you want to follow along, here is the SQL script that creates the database table and populates it with test data. I'll have the script available in the description of this video if you need it. Now, let me execute this select query so we can see the test data. Now, with this SQL interview question, the interviewer is basically checking if you know how to write user-defined functions and how to use SQL Server built-in functions, especially PAT index, that is pattern index, and stuff. We discussed user-defined functions in detail in our SQL Server tutorial for beginners course. Please check out the videos from parts 30 to 33. We also discussed PAT index and stuff functions in part 24. I'll include the link to the course page in the description of this video. Now, remember, what we really want to do is, from a given alphanumeric string column, we want to extract numbers and alphabets into their own columns. And here is the completed query for that. First, let me execute this. We have the output as expected. In this SQL query, we are using two user-defined functions, UDF underscore extract numbers and UDF underscore extract alphabets. The input for both these functions is the same alphanumeric column that contains both alphabets and letters, ID name column from our test table. And as the name implies, this function, UDF underscore extract numbers, extracts numbers from the alphanumeric column and returns them as part of this ID column. And this function, extract alphabets, again, as the name implies, extracts alphabets and returns them as part of this name column. The implementation of both these functions is pretty straightforward if we really understand how to use built-in PAT index and stuff functions. First, let's take a look at extract numbers user-defined function. We are creating a user-defined function, so create function, the name of the function, and to this function, we want to pass our alphanumeric string as an input, so we have an input parameter, and it is going to return the extracted numbers as a string. And here is the implementation, pretty straightforward. We are using both these functions, PAT index and stuff. Obviously, we are also using the while loop. Now, take a look at this PAT index function. It has got two input parameters, the pattern that we want to search for, and that's the first parameter, and the input string within which we want to look for this pattern. Now, let me include a simple select statement that explains the use of PAT index. Our input string contains both alphabets and numbers. And here is the pattern. To specify the pattern, I'm using a regular expression here. Basically, with this regular expression 0 to 9 within brackets specifies that we want to look for a number within this input string. But then we are also using this little caret symbol here just before 0. That means we want to do the opposite. Look for any non-numeric character. Basically, this is going to return us the first occurrence of a non-numeric character from this string. And if you look at this input string, we have an alphabet at position 1. So when we execute this query, we should get the value 1. Now, let's remove this letter A from this input string and then execute the same query. Notice, now we have the value 2 as the result. Why? Well, that's because within this input string, we have the first occurrence of a non-numeric character, this letter B, at position 2. Now, what do you think is going to happen if we don't have any non-numeric characters at all within the input string? Well, let's see it in action. Let's make a copy of this query and then include only numbers within our input string. The result is 0. So this means if this specified pattern is not found in this input string, then this pat index function returns 0. That's the reason we are checking here if the index is greater than 0. If it is greater than 0, then within this input string, we found a non-numeric character, and we want to remove that non-numeric character. For that, we are using the built-in function stuff. Now let's understand this function with a simple example. Let me paste a query here. We are using stuff function, and the first parameter here is our input string. And within this string, we have the first occurrence of a non-numeric character at position 2, because that's where we have letter B. So we want to replace this letter B. That's why we specify its position here, 2. And we want to replace just this one letter, and that is specified by this third parameter, how many characters you want to replace. In our case, we only want to replace this one non-numeric character. And with what we want to replace it? With an empty string. Okay, so when we execute this, this letter B must be gone from our input string, meaning the result should be 1, 2, C, 3. Okay, let's execute this. There we go. Now let's copy this result and specify this as the input string. Now, where do we have the first occurrence of a non-numeric character within this input string? Well, this letter C is present at position 3. So here we specify that position, and we want to replace that one character with an empty string. So when we execute this, this letter C must be gone within this input string. So we should get 1, 2, 3 as the result. So basically, the idea is both these built-in functions, that is pat index, stuff, and this while loop, are working together to remove every non-numeric character from the input string. Now, there is no need to check if this processed input string is null, because it's never going to be null. It will either contain only numbers or it will be an empty string. To keep this function implementation simple, we are simply going to return the processed input string. We'll let the calling code decide what to do if the string is empty. So let's remove this null check and alter the function. Now, we have extract alphabets user defined function here. And if you look at the implementation, it's very, very similar to extract numbers function. The only difference really is the regular expression that we are using. So with this expression, we are basically saying we want to find all non-alphabetic characters A to Z, both lower and uppercase, and then replace them with an empty string. So this function is going to return us all the alphabets in a given alphanumeric input string. And here is an example for this function usage. Let's execute it. Finally, in this select query, we're using both the user-defined functions, extract numbers and extract alphabets. When we execute this query, we have the result as expected. That's it in this video. Thank you for listening.